If you're on your way to Mars, you can't exactly turn around if your stomach hurts or if you cut your finger. So how do we solve medical emergencies in space? Hey gang, Trace here with your DNews weekly space update. Astronauts are really far from emergency rooms and hospitals if a health crisis comes up in space. As of now, only 24 people have left low Earth orbit. We've not spent that much time away from this cradle of humanity. But we are planning missions to Mars and elsewhere in deep space, and we need to figure this medical stuff out before we can go there safely. Of the around 540 people who have been to space, most of the medical issues have been due to space sickness. But there have been incidents of arrhythmia, which is a regular heartbeat, renal colics or kidney stones, and infections. Luckily, no one has been too badly injured yet. Most injuries actually occur during takeoff or landing. Of those, the most common is a near syncopal episode of orthostatic hypotension, or passing out from low blood pressure. Of course, all of this has been based on the history of space travel. The future is going to see a whole different set of issues. Chronic illness, trauma, injury, and maybe even unknown medical conditions. According to a study from the University of York in Canada, emergency incidents occur about 0.06 per person per year in the general population. So for a 2.5-year trip to Mars with 7 crew members, the math says that we will have one emergency. Unfortunately, there's no way to know what that emergency will be. So we'll just have to prepare for everything. The space shuttle would always have 2 crew medical officers trained in first aid and a Shuttle Orbiter Medical System to deal with pre-planned issues. The CMOs were trained in dealing with minor illnesses and injuries. They could give injections, provide medications or antibiotics, and even stitch their fellow crew member up. On the International Space Station, the Routine and Emergency Medical Operations Manual lists what to do for scrapes, nausea, broken bones, ulcers, infections, burns, all sorts of stuff. They even have how to handle space-based pregnancy tests. They have all the equipment they need to deal with all of that stuff, but bleeding in space isn't exactly the same as on Earth. Without gravity, blood droplets could float into eyes, mouths, and equipment, and even small arteries could spurt fluids into the air. As we venture deeper into space, surgery is going to happen, and it could be a huge mess. A neurosurgeon in Pittsburgh came up with the idea of putting a fluid-filled dome over an open bleeding wound. The water pressure and surface tension could stem the bleeding until the surgeon could sew it closed. It's been built and tested, and it's going to be put through a final test on Virgin Galactic Spaceship 2 once that gets running. Before you cut someone open, though, modern doctors need to know what they're going to look at and find in there. This month, a group of Stanford students tested a portable ultrasound machine in microgravity on the famed Vomit Comet, a special 747 that lets people simulate microgravity by flying in parabolas. The ultrasound works fine here on the ground, but in space, because of microgravity, things behave differently. This means they needed to test it and alter the design parameters so it will work properly up there. The lead student told Popular Science, "Astronauts will need everything we have on a ground-based ER available to them up in space, and they'll need to make sure that they all work properly." This is a big job, guys. There are other things being implemented and tested in the years leading up to our deep space missions. They're testing communications uplinks so astronauts can confer with doctors on the ground, and medical devices to use in case of everything that they can think to plan for. The portable ultrasound machine works great, by the way, so hopefully they'll have that one to check off the list. What are your biggest space fears? Tell us about it in the comments, and maybe we'll make an episode about it here on DNews. Thanks for watching, everybody. Subscribe for more. See ya.